Hey streamers, in this video I'm going to be talking about how you can broadcast on your WordPress website with WpStream and Zoom. So we received a lot of requests on a tutorial on how to do this, and if you have a school, a business, and you have been meeting online with your colleagues or your peers, this is the best way that you can broadcast on your WordPress website, have multiple users broadcasting at the same time, and also sharing the link with others so that they can watch your live stream. So the first thing I'm doing is making sure I have the WpStream plugin installed and activated so that you can use it for video streaming. And once you are assured that it's activated, go to WpStream credentials and either sign in if you already have an account or create an account by clicking right over here. And once you have entered your details and registered, it will take you to your WpStream dashboard, where you will find your free trial package and you can get an extra 5 GB of streaming data by confirming your email address. Then go back, enter your details, save your changes, and now you can see that I am connected. Then I'll go to channels, and you can either create a free or pay-per-view channel depending on your preference. I am going to be doing a free channel for now, but if you would like to find out how to create a pay-per-view channel, make sure you check out one of the videos that we have posted. So I'm just going to be adding a title, adding a featured image, and publishing this channel. So after I have published it, let me run you through Zoom. So we all know about Zoom, of course. So first, you will have to make sure you create an account and purchase one of the plans. So the thing is, you can't carry out custom RTMP streaming with a free basic account. So you will either need a pro, business, or enterprise. We currently have the pro for small teams. And yeah, so go to your account. Under account management, you will find account settings. So click on that and make sure you are on the meeting tab. Go to in meeting advanced and scroll all the way down until you find the live stream option. So allow live streaming of meetings and enable it. Once again, click on enable. And you will see Facebook and YouTube, but you will want to click on custom live streaming service, and you can provide some instructions if you want, and then save. Once saved, you will go ahead and schedule a meeting. I'm just going to enter any details. You can change the timings, dates, and everything. You can add your own passcode if you want. Allow participants to join anytime. You can also record your meeting on a local computer or to the cloud and save. After saving, go back to WpStream, and you can also record your live stream over here and create a pay-per-view video on demand later. But for now, I'm just going to start a live event without recording it. And this will take about 1 to 2 minutes, and after it has loaded, you will click on Go Live with External Broadcaster and find a server and stream key. So you will enter the server and stream key into Zoom by scrolling down to this page, Configure Custom Streaming Service, and here is the stream URL that you will enter your server and the stream key into the stream key section. Now there's also a URL, so this is the URL that you will share with any viewer that you want, so anyone can watch the broadcast. They don't necessarily have to take part in the Zoom call. Go back, copy invitation, and you can send this via email to anyone who wants to join the Zoom. So this is the same steps as usual if you are familiar with Zoom. And after you've done that, you can start this meeting. Click open, and it will take you straight to this player. So we are currently live, and let me show you how the guest will view this process. So let's say they have received this email, and you will copy the meeting ID, which is right over here. Go to Zoom, so the app in this situation, paste the meeting ID and join. It will ask you for a passcode as well. So go back and copy the passcode from the email. Paste it and continue. Now you'll be asked how you want the audio to play or any video details. And here you are live. So this is on your phone. And if we switch back to the host and how they view it, this is how it looks like. Here is the guest joining. You will go back to your WordPress website and click on View Channel. And it will appear like so. So here it is. So the host, the guest, they're both live at the moment. And this link can be shared with anyone. So anyone can view the Zoom call live. They don't have to join unless they obviously have an invitation to join with all the details. And once the guest is ready to leave, they'll just click on Leave Meeting and they will automatically get off the Zoom call. And if you switch to the host, and if they click on end, or if you click on end meeting for all, you go back to your WordPress website and you will see that this message will appear. And that is basically it on how you can go live on your WordPress website with Zoom. So once again, this is great if you have schools, businesses, webinars, and anything that requires interaction between multiple people, hosts, and multiple users. I hope that you've enjoyed this video and see you soon with another one. Bye.